Hello everyone, today we're gonna have a look at the auxiliary radiator for C7 Corvette. I have a C7 Corvette that has the Z51 performance package, which means it does have an oil to water heat exchanger, which I think it's a pretty good heat exchanger. However, when the water travels back to the radiator, it does add some additional heat. This is not a big problem unless I noticed on some hot track days that the car is a little bit overheating. It's not going into limp mode, but it does overheat and I don't like that. So that's why I purchased the auxiliary radiator, because this will get installed between the heat exchanger and the normal radiator to cool down the water and hopefully reduce temperatures. So that's why I bought it. Now let's see what I got in the package. I just want to mention that I ordered the GM Performance auxiliary radiator kit from eBay, but as we're gonna have a quick look, I don't think that's exactly what I got, but rather the parts from the kit. So the first part, and the most important one of course, is the radiator. It's not a very big radiator, but I think it's maybe a multi-purpose radiator that can be used for what I needed. It does have a lot of codes on it. It's made in Canada. So this part, I think it's a good one. It's from GM, and it should be the one that, you know, does its job cooling the water. Now that radiator needs to be fixed in this bracket. This is how the bracket will be installed. Basically, if this is the normal radiator from the car, that's how this auxiliary radiator will be installed, and it will clamp on here to the plastic that it's find underneath. And obviously we need to cut a pattern so it will fit. This bracket has some space for the bolts that will hold it in place. Okay, so we have the radiator, we have the bracket, now we have these ducts. These are obviously coming right here, right? So one is here, one is here. I was mentioning earlier that I don't think this is the original GM Performance kit, because in the original kit, these ducts should end directly with this fitting, and I see here is an adapter. Oh, that's not the end of the world, because it's lightweight and doesn't look all that bad. However, on the other one, this is the adapter that I received. So I don't think you can tell from the video, but this adapter is much heavier than both these pipes. Maybe only the radiator is heavier than this, so this piece of crap is not going to be installed on my Corvette. This looks like there is one piece right here, then some other adapter right here, and then the final fitting that goes in here, the third one, just so you can put it like this, right? So yeah, this is heavy. I'm not gonna use such thing on my Corvette. And I'll see, maybe I'll cut the duct here and order an aluminium fitting and weld it on, and then it will be nice and seamless. Or maybe I'll order, there is another oil connector from GM that you can just fit in here. It's a 90 degree connector. It's made from some sort of plastic, but it's easy and should fit better. Okay, then I got in the kit these hoses. Are two hoses right here. These are 16 millimeter hoses. Again, I don't think they are original ones from the GM performance kit. I have removed one and I'll show you why. First of all, it says made in USA and it's 2009, so I don't have a problem being made in US or being 2009 as long as they're good, but for sure they're not the original ones. And they come wrapped in this. Yeah, I'm not sure if it's very useful. We'll see if I got it installed. Then we have this. Let's see what it says. It's a seal. Yes, this is a seal that should come installed. Once the radiator sits like this, the seal should come like this, installed and seal the air. But I don't think I'm gonna use this seal, and I'll tell you why. So in the kit I should have also have a pattern, so I know how to cut off the plastic from underneath the radiator. Again, I don't think it's the original kit. I think I just ordered some parts and put them together, so that's why I don't have that pattern. So what I'll do, I will draw a pattern exactly with this, with this bracket, cut it out, and install the radiator. I don't see why we should cut off more than the radiator. I mean, more than this space where the air goes through. I saw the pattern on the internet, and they cut out here and here, and then add this air seal. But I don't understand why, because this doesn't come. These two fittings are not touching the upper side of the plastic, so I don't know. I'll not cut it out, and then I will not use this foam, this this seal. Okay, then again we have this two brackets that we're gonna use right here to fix this in the plastic. Of course, the bolts. These plastic clips are actually for that foam seal that I don't think I'm gonna use. And then for the hoses, we have this. Again, I don't think these are original clamps. Anyway, I think the kit will work. I mean, the radiator is good, the bracket is good, the pipes are usable. However, I don't think the pipes are the original one. I don't think the hoses are the original one. And I don't think I'm gonna use that foam. But we'll see. We'll put it together, and next I'll try to install them. Thank you. This is everything that came with the kit. The pipes. One fitting, the second fitting, the bracket, of course the radiator. Another two brackets that will hold the bigger bracket in place this seal, the hoses, and those clamps.